All right, so let's see. Not too bad. But I wonder what this does right here. Huh. Yes. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. So if you haven't guessed already, this is a Mauser C96. No, not really, unfortunately. But this is actually something really cool. It can be shipped right to your door. This is a replica of a Mauser C96, and it is an air gun that shoots BBs. So the Mauser C96, you've probably seen in old World War I video games up until World War II. That's because it is a very famous semi-automatic pistol design. This right here is the pistol M712. Again, it is an air gun shooting BBs that are .177, and they run on 12 grams of CO2 cartridges that go in the magazine. All right, so the magazine, you can tell right here, is detachable. So that is something that was not a thing with the real C96. It was an internal box magazine fed by a stripper clip on the top, but this still holds true to many of the other design features for the original handgun. It holds 18 rounds in the magazine, drop free, semi-automatic, as well as full auto. Only 360 feet per second though, so it's not super fast. Think airsoft gun, just basic stuff you'd pick up at Walmart or something like that. So it's not super powerful, but it is still a joy to shoot. Let's take a closer look. So for this review, we are running the high-grade CO2 12-count box of Umarex 12-gram CO2 cartridges. I've already gone through a few of these already, kind of testing this out, making sure she runs good. We also have a 1500-count that's almost half gone of steel BBs, as well as a 1500-count of the new Hornady Black Diamond, which is just a kind of a step above, a little bit more quality control there from your typical steel or copper BBs. And then of course you have the C96 Mauser replica as well. So in the box, you will find this wrench right here. That is designed to go in a slot on the bottom right here, which is a steel reinforced plastic and rubber O-ring design plug, essentially, to go ahead and plug and push up your cartridge into the needle where the air can flow through. You can see there's a hole there on top of the CO2 cartridge, so make sure you dispose of that properly. Throw that away. Go ahead and get a fresh cartridge out here from your box, and there's a needle on the bottom, so you don't just want to throw these in there, risk puncturing it, risk ruining one of your CO2 cartridges, not going to come flying out at you or anything like that. Go ahead and place it like so. Start it with a hand thread until you can't go anymore, then go ahead and quickly and steadily seal this up. You'll hear a little hiss, but then go ahead and seal it and you're good to go. All right, so let's go ahead and load this up. Now to load this, there is a little knob here, and I will tell you, these things are not fun to load. Okay, so to load this up, what I usually do, and it, like I said, it's not super fun to do, but seems to work, grab a handful of BBs, make sure they don't roll off the place you're putting them on. All right, take that tab, go all the way down like so. All right, you see that? And it will lock on the bottom. That's a good and bad thing. I'll tell you that in a second. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and try not to waste too many BBs doing this. Unfortunately, this is kind of how it has to do. You go ahead and put it in that hole, like so, and then take your nail and push it, and they'll run down the tube. All right, you know, I have a Luger version of this from Umarex as well, from their classic lineup. And you guys have probably seen that, as well as the MP40 review. If you haven't seen those, check those out. These are great backyard plinkers, and I have to say, all of them were kind of annoying to load. It's just the nature of these magazine-fed BB guns. BBs are small, they're gonna escape your fingers really easily, and these holes are small. Yet you have to have nice plastic guides here to keep them together to make sure they go in there smoothly. So take your time. These are no means gonna be a tactical reload. You can probably buy spare mags as well. I'll put the link to this as well as the spare mags and the ammo and the CO2 cartridges below in the description if you guys are interested. You can get them right on Amazon for the best price by far. I'm gonna go ahead and top this off. About 18 BBs, don't overload it. It's probably about right. Try to save your remaining BBs, of course. You don't want to just waste a bunch of these and let them go on the ground to waste. So here is the tricky part. Now you have an issue where this is locked, okay? So you wanna go ahead and push this forward. Obviously it's not fully 18, this is probably like 15 or something like that, because it would be down a little bit further, but you don't wanna go too down, otherwise you will permanently lock that. And honestly, 15 might be the way to go, because if you go all the way down and lock it, when this goes and it gets inserted into the magazine well, like so, it's going to push on that part right there, and that is going to lock it back, which means you will jam or just not be able to fire any BBs. So let's go ahead and show you guys how this functions. So interestingly enough, what do you think this reminds you of? That's right, it's actually the design behind the Han Solo blaster. You've probably seen it before. I think Umarex even makes or has made in the past some collector editions that look like that blaster, but the Mauser C96 was the kind of the stepping stone from where they came from to the blaster. So you can kind of recognize that. That is the famous blaster by Han Solo in Star Wars. Of course, pew pew. That's why we did that. So pretty cool factoid there. But so let's go ahead, before we load a magazine in, let's talk about the features. Okay, so of course you have a nice long barrel. On the original C96 barrel, this made it a very accurate semi-automatic handgun at the time. Nice long barrel. You have the flip-up sights here. They flip about yay high, not too bad, but they are adjustable. Now granted, this is a very short range weapon, being a BB gun with this kind of power behind it. All right, now you do have right here this button that is a magazine release, okay? So of course, the original one did not have that, but this does. So magazine release, hammer. Interestingly enough, on the other side here, the only way to put the safety on is to actually engage the hammer back, and now you're on safe, and then down to fire. Okay, so also right here, there's a letter N and a letter R. N is semi-automatic. You simply push and drag down and back. Make sure it clicks back to the R, which means fully automatic. So I don't know what the N and R stands for, probably something in German. If any of you guys know what that might mean, maybe it means semi, maybe it means fully automatic, let me know. Let me know in the comments below. Of course, your trigger, you know, BB gun trigger, we'll talk about that. To fire the actual handgun, which is kind of cool, this is the blowback design right here, go ahead and pull back and you'll see the slide goes back and then it goes forward. You see that? That is the blowback. So that wastes more CO2, but it's just a cool factor. It's just something cool to do, and it's something really neat to kind of keep true to the design. All right, so it's a little, this makes this a little bit step above just a regular airsoft gun or a cheap BB gun or something like that. It has a nice blowback design there, and it's all steel, of course, so a nice weight to it. Some faux plastic kind of wood looking grips, lanyard, a little ring on the bottom here, kind of staying true to the design, kind of just authentic kind of look and feel to it. Heavy steel construction, Waffenfabrik M712. You have the caliber 4.5, 0.177 BB. You do not have to take this apart in any shape or form. Cleaning is gonna be simple. You're going to want to take some cloth and maybe some gun oil or some cleaning oil and clean up all of this area. Clean up a little bit in there. Clean up the guide rod. Clean up, there's a little rod in there. That would be kind of like the guide rod in there. Just clean it up a little bit here and there. There's no reason to really scrub the bore or anything like that. You probably can. You're not gonna mess it up or anything like that if you wanna run a little tiny bore snake through there with a little pad or something. But they don't recommend taking this apart in any way, shape, or form, because, I mean, there's a lot of mechanics behind it. And again, it's not, you know, it's not really designed to be taken apart. It's a BB gun. So let's go ahead and get some shooting done. So before you shoot, safety is key. Wear safety glasses. You only got two of these right here, guys. You only got two eyes. So go ahead, safety glasses, sunglasses that are rated for ballistics ratings, like these Stingers right here, link down below. I've been using these for the range, as well as just exercising, biking, running, BB gun plinking, all that stuff all the time. So Stinger sunglasses, or just any kind of safety glasses, just wear something. These BBs could ricochet and you don't want to deal with that. So I went ahead and you can see there are the BBs we were loaded up earlier, fresh CO2 cartridge. You go ahead and insert the magazine like so. Go ahead and cock the hammer. You'll see the little BB in there, and the, I guess we'll call it the bolt, the bolt will grab the BB, throw it forward, and put it in here. And I believe there is actually a little viewing window on top there that you can kind of see, but it's pretty dark, especially those dark black BBs in there. So there's a little viewport right there to see if it's loaded. Go ahead and load it. Now you can go ahead and keep it on safe if you want to do like cocked and locked, like a 1911 or something like that. I don't know why you would for a BB gun, but you can do safe if you want to load it for maybe your kid and kind of teach them the fundamentals behind this, a really nice classic firearm like this. Of course, being much cheaper to buy and much cheaper ammunition with the BBs. So go ahead, you can do the safety. I'm gonna do semi-automatic, so I'm gonna go ahead, flip that button down, we're on fire. We got some cans, some vicious enemy can combatants there. It's kind of an awkward gun to hold and shoot. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, you really wanna kinda hold up here. You kinda wanna feel like that, especially I'll show it in full auto, but what I'll do is I'll shoot one-handed first. It shoots about 6 inches high. We're at 7 yards. Keep that in mind. I don't know why. All right, let's go ahead and reset, put on safety, add some more BBs, do full auto. So one is in the chamber still and it is on safe. You cannot fire it. You can load a fresh mag of 18 rounds in. You cannot fire it, so that safety does work. Nice little touch there. We're gonna go ahead and load a fresh mag. So you have about roughly 19 rounds in there right now with one in the chamber. Go ahead and flip your button over to R, full auto. Now, this is kind of a cumbersome, weird gun to shoot as it is. You can do to your typical kind of stance and hold it like this and kind of line up the shot. Again, you're gonna kind of have to shoot a little bit high just because it's kind of, or a little bit low because it's shooting a little bit high. What you could do, being how it's just a short barrel and kind of how the full auto kind of makes this thing go wonky all over the place with that blowback design. It's not crazy by any means, but still it's kind of weird and kind of cumbersome to hold. You can go ahead and hold this like so and then hold it out like this, and it provides a much more stable platform for shooting. You could probably play with these sights too to fix, depending on if you're going low or high. Not a big deal there. So, but let's go ahead and try the full auto. See if we can knock all those cans down with one mag. Safety off. That's it. So it will keep running after you empty out all the rounds, and let's see if I can run out the CO2 cartridge. You see how that worked? So you can tell you can probably get about 2.5, almost 3 magazines through on one cartridge, and when it's done, it lets you know it's done. It's going to just kind of sputter, and you're gonna see, actually, even like after the first mag, you're gonna see the round start kind of drooping and not as powerful. But again, that's the blowback design. It's not gonna be super powerful. It's not a hunting round kind of air gun or anything like that. But again, awesome, awesome little Mauser reproduction. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this review on this little C96 air gun reproduction right here. I think they did a great job. Umarex does a great job with the whole Legend series. I'll drop a link below, like I said, to the Amazon page, as well as all the stuff we're using today from the BBs and the CO2 cartridge and things like that. This thing seems to run very reliable. I haven't had a jam yet. Same with my Luger, I haven't had a jam yet. You really just want to run quality BBs through it, like the Umarex Steel or the Hornady Black. Those seem to run just fine. Of course, you know, this isn't 100% reproduction. It is kind of has some kind of quirks to it with like a detachable magazine and things like that to fit the modern CO2 cartridge in here and the rounds that are needed, because it is a single stack magazine there. But overall, it looks great, it feels great, and it's nice and heavy. So if you can't afford a premium priced real C96, these can be shipped right to your door, and they are a load of fun and a great kind of training tool for maybe your kids to kind of learn about some of these classic firearms that they're already seeing in video games. So awesome deal right here, guys. So go ahead, click that link below if you're interested. Subscribe to the channel, like this video. If you have any questions at all surrounding this, hit them in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer them. I'll go ahead and also like our Facebook page, Outdoor Enthusiast Channel. If I ever see these on sale, I'll go ahead and post links to that, as well as all the other products that I kind of find online for sale. So if you follow me there, you'll see all the deals kind of come through. So, well, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next review.